Okay, we are now at principle one overview workspace, and we see a number of projects here. So some projects has images captioned here associated with them. Those indicate that those projects contain images. There is one video project, two projects with point cloud episodes, and two projects with volumetrical medical data. Let me first focus on image labeling interfaces. So I will open this project. And before I start showing you various labeling interfaces, let me speak about two important notions, which are classes and tags. And you will see these ideas of classes and tags for videos, LiDAR data, and medical data as well. So whenever we speak about spatial annotations, we usually use classes. So, for example, in this example, there is a class cat, which is associated with polygon shape, and we will use polygons to label cats in this case. There is a dog class, which has shape type equal any shape. So it means that we can use any shape when we label dogs. And there is also a person class that is associated with rectangular shape. I personally like to specify the shapes explicitly, but sometimes to use any shape is also quite convenient. So classes is about spatial annotations, and tags are about attributes. So we might want to specify attribute for, say, the entire image. Maybe we want to say that the image is indoors, taken indoors or outdoors. And in this case, those two tags allow us to do that, and you see also hotkeys associated with these tags. We may also go further and specify certain attributes for objects. So, for example, we may want to say that cat or dog has a certain size, or say body position, say for persons. Okay, once we spoke a bit about this class and tags idea, let's go and open some labeling interfaces. And I will start with this basic image labeling toolbox, the first one. Let me open the images. So we have, in this case, just three images. Maybe I will close some advanced tabs here. And say my first task is to tag the entire image. So this image is outdoors. I can press a hotkey and the tag will appear. And then I will say that this image is taken indoors. And I may use just interface and do not rely on hotkeys. So this is outdoors image. So we have just assigned tags to the images. Let's start working with spatial annotations. So let's first label persons here. So I will pick a class called person, and I will use this instrument to label the first person, and I will go to the next frame and label, I will go to the next image and label two more persons here. So, and once I do that, I will specify additional attributes. I will specify additional attributes for each person. So, okay, probably this is more or less correct. Okay, let's do it this way. Okay, so we have labeled three persons, and maybe we would like to specify some properties on top. Maybe we want to attach some properties to each of the persons that we have labeled. And one way is to select an object and say, okay, would like to specify body position. And in this case, body position is sitting. Okay. And we can see that we have attached, we have associated a body position to this person. And let me also specify body positions for two more persons. So I will select the first person here and just say that the person is standing, and I can do the same for the second person. So I will just select the person here and say that body position is actually standing. Now let's move on to the next class that we have specified, and I think that we can probably start with the cat class. So for the cat, we said that that we will use polygon tools. And say, when I click polygon tool here, it shows me the available classes. So for dog I can use any class, for cat I can use only polygons. So let me label the cat here. So it will take me a bit of time to label it in a more or less precise way. So manual labeling is always slow and hard. And in the second section of this video, I will talk a lot about AI models and their usage to speed up the processes like those. So you will see how much faster it will be when we rely on AI models to label for semantic segmentation task, for example. Okay, so I'm almost done. Maybe I should just lower precision a bit just to speed up the labeling process. Okay, let me do that. Okay, just several more points. Almost there. Okay, let's stop here. So we have labeled a cat with polygon. Let me feed this image to the screen. And maybe I would like also to specify attribute for the cat in this case. And maybe I would like to say that this cat has, say, average size. So, and we see that the effect of putting the tag here. So let's just deal with dogs. And for dogs we can use any shapes. And the reason why I allow it in this case is just to illustrate a bit more labeling instruments here. So for example, I may use a brush tool like this. I deliberately avoid AI-assisted tools here in this section because I will focus a lot on them on the next section. Okay, let me just do something like that. Again, my annotation might be not super precise, but I'll do my best. And then I may say, okay, let's kind of fill in the pixels here. And we can also like make some adjustments here if we want, like this. Okay, so that's an example how we can use this brush instrument. But we are not restricted to the brush instrument, so since the dog has any shape, so I, here for example I may label the dog with just a rectangle like this, and let me label the dog here with just a point. So I may pick a point and label the dog in this kind of fashion. As a last step, let me quickly attach attributes to the dogs that I have labeled. So I may pick a dog here and define a size for the dog. So maybe it's like, let's say it's an average dog. We can click here to see the attribute. And we will go to the next image and say for this dog, we'll say that, okay, maybe it's a large dog. Let's define an attribute here. And let's do the same for the last dog for this point, so we can actually assign attributes to the points as well. So maybe it's like average dog here. Okay. Now let me open the same images into in the slightly different labeling interface. So I may use this labeling interface also to perform labeling operations, and we see kind of the same data that we labeled in the previous labeling interface here. This is slightly more advanced. This labeling interface is slightly more advanced in a way that it may allow me to, for example, do some operations on top of groups of objects. So maybe I can just select all the objects here, and maybe I can move all the objects somewhere at once. Sometimes it might be quite convenient. Let me actually try to undo these changes here to put these boxes where they were. Another important characteristic of this interface is that it's kind of more scalable when we have quite a number of objects, maybe thousands of objects on images and large images in general. So what I could do here is to open another project. So we just have one class here defined, sunflower seed. Those images are not that high resolution, but I hope to illustrate the idea. So say if I open an image in this labeling interface, what I can do with this labeling interface, for example, is to enable this navigation bar and just to work with some areas of interest in the images. And say if I have thousands of objects on the image, the number of objects will be like, when I work with specific tile here, will be restricted, and the labeling interface in general becomes way more responsive in this case. So let me just probably show you how we can use, say, a brush tool. Probably I have to decrease the size of that, so like this, and let me just use this brush tool to label, say, one object here. Just, it's not very precise, but anyway, I hope it illustrates the point here. So, and we can use other labeling instruments here to label objects in this labeling interface. Okay, so there is one last thing that I want to show when it comes to basic labeling interfaces for images, and it's the ability to navigate over images. So this feature exists in both interfaces, in both labeling interfaces. Say if I have a relatively large number of images, and I might want to find specific images. So I may want to define a filter that will allow me to find images that contain, say, a specific class, maybe say bicycle. And maybe even more than that, maybe I want to see images with, say, three bicycles or more. And in this case, I see four images like this. So here we should see three bicycles labeled, and the same here, three or more in this case. So I think that's more or less it, and let's move to the next modality.